On behalf of Chairman Harvey Godwin Jr., the Tribe of Council, the Lumbee staff, approximately 55,000 Lumbee people, we welcome you to the Lumbee Tribe of North Carolina. I'm honored and humbled to be the tribal administrator of the Lumbee people. My name is Doc Edward Locklear Jr. Allow me the opportunity to tell you a few things about myself. I'm the youngest son of 13 siblings that were born into the family of Doc Locklear Sr. and Mary Lowry Locklear of the Saddle Tree community. My great-grandfather from my mother's side was Purdy Lowry, the brother of Henry Barry Lowry. My grandfather on my daddy's side was William Locklear, who was a prominent farmer in the Saddle Tree community. At this time, we'd like to recognize the current tribal members, if they would please stand. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. We'd also like to recognize our tribal court. Please stand. Give them a round of applause also. And how about our past tribal council members? Are there any of them present tonight, this evening? Please stand. Any elected officials in the audience, please stand. It's only by the grace of God that we are all here today. My God woke us up this morning. He clothed us in a reasonable portion of mind, health, and strength. Only God can do that. It is nothing that we've done, but it was only through the mercy and the power of God that each one of us are sitting here today. We're sitting in this building, which is one of seven of our Boys and Girls Complex that is strategically located within our four-county service area. These buildings are the people's building. We are humbled and we're thankful that you are all here today. This day is very important to the Lumbee people. It's so important that the founding fathers of the Lumbee Tribe of North Carolina proposed in a constitution that was adopted on November the 16th, 2001 by the membership of the Lumbee Tribe that the following. Article 8 of the Constitution, chairperson, all executive power, including implementation of and compliance with annual budgets of the Lumbee Tribe of North Carolina shall reside within the tribal chairperson, who shall cause all laws of the tribe to be faithfully executed. Specifically, the tribal chairman shall deliver a general membership an annual state of the tribe address during the first week in July, which address shall include a proposed budget for the upcoming years. At this time, I'd like to call Brother Tim Chavis to the microphone.
Well, we want to go in prayer. If you missed the prayer service this morning, you missed a wonderful event we had, enjoyed it, and just had a very spiritual moment in there, and God was moving in a mighty way. We're going to go in prayer. I want you to stand. We want to pray for James. He had a spell out in the parking lot, and the EMS service is out there now, I think, working with him. So as we go in prayer, we want to remember Mr. James Locklear, our photographer. So let's lift him up in prayer. And you may have a pressing need on your heart. You want to lift that up too. So let's look to the Lord in prayer. Father, We thank you for this time, and we thank you for your love and your mercy. We thank you, Father, for all that is being done here in our tribe and with our council and our chairman, our executive director, and all the employees. We just pray your hand upon them, and we just pray that you continue to bless them and lead them and guide them. Give them wisdom and direction. You said, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask you, and you would give to all men. And you do it in a liberal way, Father. You don't upbraid us because we ask. So we pray that you'll give them wisdom. We pray for Brother James right now, Lord. We don't know what's going on and what has happened to him, but we just pray that you would speak to his heart right now, touch his body, and encourage him. The EMS personnel that are working with him, we pray that you'll touch them and give them wisdom. And we pray for every person on these grounds. We pray that whatever need may exist in the hearts and the lives of the people here, that you'll meet every need according to your riches and glory. And again, it is a joy to be able to call you our Father and to lift up our tribal group before you, our tribe, our administrator, all the employees and the council. Father, we pray you hand a blessing upon them. Bless this time as our brother comes to give the state of the tribe. We just pray that you'll give him wisdom and direction and clarity as he speaks this day. We commit all this to you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. God bless you. May be seated.
Trying to know. get no rest. 'Cause there's no rest, there's no rest, there's no
Thank you very much. I, along with our tribal administrator, am honored and humbled to stand up here and sing and perform for this momentum and monumental occasion. The song Backbone referenced many prominent men throughout the history of the United States. Benjamin Franklin, one of our founding fathers, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the leader of the civil rights movement, and closer to home, a Tuscarora outlaw by the name of Henry Barry Lowry. The next gentleman that is about to take the stage embodies backbone and understands the meaning, the message, and the symbolism in the word. Before he took the title of tribal chairman, he was thinking of ideas and innovative ways to renew the faith, instill the pride and dignity in our people, and I think he's done a great job thus far. Please help me welcome to the stage the Honorable Tribal Chairman of the Lumbee people, Mr. Harvey Godwin, Jr.
Thank you so much. Well, this has been a great day so far. I would like to recognize Charlie Lowry again, a Lumbee woman with beauty, intelligence, talent, and a spiritual woman. But we have thousands of Lumbee women that have those same attributes and more. And right now, I'd like to recognize all Lumbee women. I'd also like to recognize my family, my wife Sheila, my son Quinn, my son Cody Eaglehorse, my granddaughter Journey, and my brother Roger. Please stand. That's where your backbone comes from in a lot of ways, is from your family. And also, worried about James right now, my good friend and my brother. I'm hoping he's okay. Today, as mandated in Article 8, Paragraph 1A, by the Constitution adopted by the Lumbee Tribe, I present to you, the General Membership, the annual State of the Tribe Address. We have made tremendous strides in the past 6 months, building lasting partnerships, exploring new opportunities, and strengthening our government and the services we provide. I am excited to share and highlight our most recent events, accomplishments, and goals, and to present to you the current state of the tribe. Immediately upon entering the office of chairman, I was personally invited by United States Congressman Richard Hudson to be his guest at the State of the Union Address in Washington, D.C. Since that time, I've had the opportunity to build many beneficial relationships for our people with officials such as U.S. Senator Richard Burr, U.S. Senator Tillis, Congressman Pinninger, Attorney General Roy Cooper, UNC System President Margaret Spellings, and various tribal leaders. And over this time was also held true and fast to the core Lumbee values, which are belief in God, value of an education, protecting our culture and our identity, and our connection to the land, our land and environment. In addition to building new bridges with our government representatives, the Lumbee Tribe has hosted numerous events that directly impact and sustain our people and way of life. Our Day of Prayer, our fourth one today, has become an ongoing tribal event. Our recognition of Hayes Pond Memorial Day service at the Cultural Center and federal recognition tree planting stand out as important events to honor our heritage. We have hosted other events such as the Lumbee Nation Economic Summit, the Pembroke Chamber Rise and Shine, the Legal Aid of North Carolina's annual meeting. These events strengthen our community ties, as do our partnerships with Walmart and programs such as First Bank Affinity Program and Camel Soup's Volunteer Program. Most recently, we partnered with The Longest Walk, an effort led by Dennis Banks, the co-founder of American Indian Movement, allowing us once again to build and strengthen bridges on a national scale. While building bridges with our neighbors, we have hit the ground running to evaluate tribal operations and services and programs as well. I have made several changes across the board. Today, all tribal services are in one centralized location, allowing members greater access to services and saving a total of $32,000 annually on leases and utilities. Only the Veterans Office remains at ComTech, near the community-based outreach clinic. Also, all service programs have been extended Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Hours have also been extended to our Boys and Girls Clubs, Summer hours are narrowed from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. to provide parents better access to the services offered by our youth department. Our Office of Enrollment has made changes to better service our members by offering free tribal membership cards and for new enrollments and for free updates on tribal cards that have not expired. We also work with the North Carolina Board of Elections to allow Lumbee Tribal Enrollment Cards to be used as North Carolina voter IDs. We have made several changes in our operations. We have provided our main facility, the Tribal Housing Complex, with on-site security. We replaced the roofs and installed new doors at Red Hill Apartments and Hawkeye Sands Apartments, also received new doors. We also replaced the wooden ramps with composite decking at one of our elderly sites, Heritage Haven. This decking type is maintenance-free, safer, and enhances the beauty of the site. We've also are establishing playgrounds at Red Hill and Hawkeye Sands. And the reason for the playgrounds is because at Valentine's Day, the children of Red Hill presented me with a box, shoebox full of Valentine's cards requesting a safe environment in which to play. I'm glad to say that their playground equipment will arrive in 2 weeks. We hit several milestones these past few months. We recently constructed your 175th home for an enrolled tribal family. Your senior Miss Lumbee pageant earlier this week had a record attendance, and we have with us today Miss Wanda Locklear McCall, your new senior Miss Lumbee. Please stand. We also had record attendance at our spring powwow with over 30 tribes being represented. It was the first time the powwow was held at the Culture Center in over 11 years. Dance of the Spring Moon Powwow was streamed live just as this event is today. We have a strong groundwork on which to build. Looking ahead, the administration has a 3 to 5 year strategic and comprehensive plan for our programs and services they provide for the Lumbee members. The proposed budget items directly correspond with these goals. For the next few years, low-income housing energy assistance program will focus on financial education and counseling. We aim to make a long-term impact on the lives of our tribal members, educating them on the importance of personal financial management. These changes do take time, but they can ultimately reduce the cost of tribal memberships. Our Community Services Block Grant primarily operates the Office of Enrollment. We also plan through this program to employ an individual to provide for tribal elders to assist them in transportation to the doctor, to buy medicine, to the store, to DSS, or come into the tribal complex. We're pretty proud of this one. Our elders will continue to be a top priority for this administration. The Vocational Rehabilitation Program, which assists tribal members with disabilities in achieving gainful employment, plans to hold its first American Indian Day for high school seniors. This event would involve collaborating with Indian education and the school counselors, and would allow seniors with disabilities to discover educational and on-the-job training opportunities. We continue to serve enrolled American Indian women and children that are victims of domestic violence through our grant project, Enlightening Native Daughters. Our primary goal is to provide these families with a safe place to go when they are without hope. To this date, this project has served 316 Lumbee women and 533 Lumbee children. We will also continue to facilitate another grant project, Project Access, Achieving College Opportunities, Community Engagement, and Student Success, thanks to the partnership with the public schools in Robinson County and our new chancellor, Dr. Robin Cummins at UNC Pembroke. Through this project, we will host college fairs at our community buildings and provide our Boys and Girls Clubs as sites for UNCP to tutor students. Community camps will also be held throughout Lumbee communities, encouraging our students to further their education at community colleges or four-year institutions. Educational classes will also be held at our Changing Lifestyles Living Longer program this year. We will provide educational classes concerning chronic diseases and discuss how diet affects our overall health. We will take the first steps to preventing chronic disease with healthy eating and development of a community garden at the Culture Center with the partnership of Campbell Soup and with their main organization, which stands for Maxton American Indian Network. Our housing programs will continue to fulfill the mission of providing our members with safe, sanitary, and decent housing. Through our NAHASDA, Native American Housing and Self-Determination Act of 1996 funding, we will rehabilitate existing homes and construct new homes. We will provide rental housing for both families and the elderly. We will also provide down payment assistance, mortgage assistance, emergency assistance, transitional housing, and heating and air. In addition to these services, we plan to implement more stringent financial counseling in our home ownership program. This mandatory counseling is designed to help tribal members before they attain a tribal home and will assist families who find themselves in financial crisis during the life of their mortgage. We are excited to announce that after 5 years, we have received HUD approval to begin new construction on an early site in District 1, investing $1.6 million in the Roland community. This will consist of 8 homes and a community building. We also will gain approval from HUD Indian College Student Housing. This is important. This proposed student housing model activity 1 will consist of 4 bedrooms, 4 baths, and a common living area. We hope to construct this housing on the tribal property at the Pine Crest subdivision of Lumberton, which was purchased a few years ago and has been vacant since. This will be student housing for Lumbee's, assisting Lumbee College students at UNC Pembroke and RCC. Furthermore, we hope to gain approval from HUD for a swimming pool, model activity 2. The revitalization of the swimming pool at the Cultural Center will be used to create a healthy lifestyle and crime prevention for participants of the Boys and Girls Clubs, NAHASDA recipients, and members of the Lumbee Tribe. The Cultural Center, as mentioned earlier, along with the partnership with Campbell Soup, will be the site of a community garden designed to connect the children to the land. Youth and elders can come together in this joint venture, strengthening bonds on several levels. We also plan to implement recycling in all Boys and Girls Clubs as well as community buildings. This will continue the connection to the land as we teach our children to keep Mother Earth clean. Another proposal for which we will gain approval from HUD will be a stickball field, model activity 3. This stickball field would also be located at the Culture Center, providing more than 400 Boys and Girls Clubs participants with a place to engage in healthy competition. Students will be more active and healthier, and they will learn new skills, develop good sportsmanship, and keep our culture alive. We will also partner with UNCP to utilize the Culture Center golf course for cross-country running. Other improvements include hiring 8 Lumbee Tribal Safety Officers with police vehicles and enhanced playgrounds for our children living in our rental housing. We also will provide vouchers through Veterans Affairs supported housing of homeless veterans, as well as an array of other veteran services, including health care, job placement, counseling, and other services as needed. This plan is meant to touch all Lumbee lives. All Lumbee lives, youth, elders, that millennial group that people are still trying to define, but all Lumbee people. And the security what I'm talking about is to protect the assets of the Lumbee tribe. We have $60 million in assets in community buildings, homes, and to protect our most valued asset, our people. So I'm looking forward to this security. We also will hire in the very near future a tribal attorney who will be an employee to the tribe will help. Their first and foremost responsibility will be to act as HUD compliance officer. I'm expecting the HUD final report that you've heard so much about very soon, and I think it will be favorable to the Lumbee people. We've been talking and negotiating now since January, I think, but I'm looking forward to that report. Also, one of the things I talked about a few months ago was a fall festival. Didn't know where we were going to have it, but we will have it at the Culture Center sometime in October, and it will be a spot festival. Y'all know, you know what spots are, fish, Lumbee spots. So you get two spots, two pieces of bread, a slice of sweet potato, and a drink, and no carryouts, no covered dishes. Mr. Eric, I'm counting on you. I don't know if we can, if there's enough of tons of spots in North Carolina to do this, but I'm counting on you and others to help us get this done. Also, for the very first time, the Lumbee Tribe has been involved really closely, thanks to the efforts of Dr. Frieda Porter with the American Indian Museum in Washington, D.C., which comes under auspices of the Smithsonian Institute. First they came and we had a meeting, and they're going to erect an American Indian Veterans Memorial on the National Mall in Washington, D.C. on 2019. Lumbee artists will have the opportunity to compete for the drawing and depiction of what this monument will look like. And our own Lumbee warriors will be a strong part of this, and we're going to take a lead in this. But with that, on April 1st and 2nd, 2017, we have the date confirmed. Now I have to raise the money. I want to take 100 of our people to Washington, D.C. to have a two-day cultural event in the American Museum so that people can, the Congress can come over. It's in the peak week of the cherry blossoms blooming and see the Lumbee culture, our college sandwiches, our grape ice cream, all our foods, our songs, our artists, our people of faith, our leaders of faith, our educational leaders. I'm looking forward to that day, and I think this is a great opportunity for our people. The other thing that you may not hear much about, but the Tribal Council is discussing right now, along with me and others, is Tribal 8A. Tribal 8A certification is a special set-aside certification that can be achieved by tribal governments. And we're the only one in North Carolina that has one. You take this tribal certification and you can build businesses and get contracts with the federal government to make money. So this has been in place for several years before I even got here. But in my hand, I hold with you, I'm showing you is the bylaws for Lumbee Tribal Holdings and Lumbee Tribal Enterprises. And how I want to try to break this down for just a couple of minutes is, the Lumbee Tribe has two ways of having funds. One is a nonprofit, our 501c3, through Lumbee Land Development, where all our services go down through. On the other side is the Lumbee Tribe, which owns a company. You actually own a company called Lumbee Tribal Holdings. Underneath it, Lumbee Tribal Holdings owns Lumbee Tribal Enterprises. So go back up. Lumbee Tribal Enterprises has Ron Oxendine, who is the main person that goes out and gets contracts and is working on getting contracts for the Lumbee Tribe under Lumbee Tribal Enterprises. So when these contracts become live, all this was done with the SBA, Small Business Administration, through Washington, D.C. But these companies were built for the future of the Lumbee people. So when these contracts become live through Lumbee Tribal Enterprises, they start making money. The profits move up into the board of Lumbee Tribal Holdings. Lumbee Tribal Holdings takes that money on where you say it should go, how it should be spent. Whether you have a full fair recognition or not, here's profits that we can use to bolster every program we have, to start scholarships, to build better homes, to help people in various ways, to build our community, to build our tribe up. So we can use those prophets to do that. But the thing is, I want you to take away from this is this. The tribal council and I will be having more discussions about this. But always remember, it's your money. It's not my money. It's not the tribal council's money. It's not the tribal employees' money. It's the Lumbee tribe membership's money. So I'm depending on you to hold us accountable. I'm depending on you to make sure we are fiscally responsible. I want you to make sure that every dime that's spent, that you know where it's going and what it's going for, and that it's good for the people. A little bit about full federal recognition. In 1888, there were 45 men, I think it's 45, that signed a document that was sent to Washington, D.C., to the Bureau of Indian Affairs, which was under the War Department, if that tells you anything, back then. And they were asking for us to be recognized as Indians, and they were asking for services to help with Indian Normal School. It was just starting up 1 year later. It took 2 years, and Congress finally said, yes, you're Indians, we know you are, but we have no money. Bye. 2 years before that, 3 years before that, 1885, there was a man called Hamilton McMillan. Hamilton McMillan. His statue was right in front of Old Main, off to the side. This is a full Scottish man that lived in Red Springs, who was an educator and a lawyer. But for some reason, I don't know if he started talking to one of our Lumbee women or what happened, but he went crazy over Lumbee people and researched it. So with that, in 1885, he got elected to the North Carolina General Assembly. And he is the one who had us recognized by the state for the first time as Croatan Indians of Robinson County. And he is the one that got the educational fund started before Old Main was, before Indian Normal School even started, to get money so we could have our own education. Then, in 1887, he got the funds to build the first building at the Indian Normal School. This was a great man on behalf of the Lumbee people. But I'm telling you all that to tell you this. Take politics out of it, and that's one thing I've been trying to do, and it's hard to do, is separate politics from this. But there's a man, U.S. Senator Richard Burr. I've met with him several times. The chair of the Federal Recognition Committee is sitting right there, Mr. Jared Lowry. He knows him and others. But this man, he was raised by his father, which is a minister, and I don't know why he's doing it. I don't even think he knows why he's doing it. But this man, I trust and believe, is the next Hamilton McMillan. He wants to help the Lumbee people. He's the man that's going to achieve full federal recognition for us. He's boss over the rest of them, and he can make it happen. He's the top 5 senator in the U.S. Senate right now. If he wins his election again, he may be number 1. And if he can't do it, I don't know what to tell you. But this is the man. He's the next Hamilton McMillan. He's the one I'm counting on to help us get it done. You're going to hear some news from this very soon. There's going to be some movement, so be looking out for that. And it's not going to be the old way of just doing things like we used to. Go walk the halls of Congress and bang on doors, and maybe you'll get to talk to an aide. I've done that twice already, so have many other people. But when a man tells you he has a plan and trust him and follow that plan, that's what I'm going to step out and do. So, but there'll be more information on that. I'm looking forward to that day because full federal recognition, along with our tribal 8A, you're talking about 100 years from now, like Dr. Cummins and I talk about so much. You're talking about 100 years out now, 100 years out of prosperity for the Lumbee people. It's been a busy morning, and I just got off the phone about 2 hours ago with this, and I want to read this to you. This is going to be released today in the Raleigh News and Observer. I'm sure the Robertsonian is going to pick up on it today. But you all know about the Anheuser-Busch problem we had, and here's the result of that. I've been waiting and negotiating. We finally got to this point. But the Lummi Tribe and R.A. Jeffries are pleased to announce that they have agreed to resolve the dispute between them concerning the use of two of the Lummi Tribe's trademarks and advertisements created by R.A. Jeffries. The agreement included a resolution of all claims against Anheuser-Busch and R.A. Jeffries. The use of the Lummi Tribe's trademarks in those ads was a mistake that arose out of a misunderstanding for which R.A. Jeffries takes responsibility and apologizes. The Lummi Tribe accepts that apology. As a show of his support for the local community, the Lummi Tribe, R.A. Jeffries, is pleased to announce that he has agreed to make a substantial donation to Lummi Land Development Incorporated, a 501c3 nonprofit organization that serves the Lummi Tribe. The money will be used for education or youth programs. Both the Lummi Tribe and R.A. Jeffries are committed to moving forward from this experience in a positive and mutually respectful way. Thank you. That was a hard one to do. I want to talk again about unity. I'm going to talk about it till I can't talk about it anymore. And that's when I'm dead. But our people have to unify. I already see it. I see it in our youth. I see our young people coming up and embracing their culture again. I see young men, youth, making drums. Our drummers and our singers and powwow are as good as anybody in the nation. War paint's been accepted. The first tribal drum group from the east of the Mississippi to be personally invited to go to Gathering of the Nations next spring in New Mexico. James Locklear went out and grabbed Ashton Locklear and brought her here, and she re-engaged with her connection to the Lummi people. And she spoke to our Boys and Girls Club, and she's going to be a Lummi woman that's going to be on the worldwide media representing us, I hope, as an Olympian. But unity starts with everybody in this room. You know, it starts with all of us. That's why we pray. That's why God has sustained us as a people. He wants us to be unified with ourselves and be unified with Mother Earth and be unified with Him. You know, I saw some guys in the gym the other day, and I said, we were just talking about ISIS and all this stuff you've been hearing about. And I said, you think ISIS can recruit a Lumbee to join them? And one of them looked at me and said, man, our people is too rooted in the Lord for that to happen. So, but I tell you, everything I've just described, I know it's a little bit different. It's going to take time, but all these moving parts we got through the tribal council, through this administration, as long as I'm here, and with you overseeing us, we have a great opportunity to do great things for all our people and show the world how powerful we really are. Sometimes we don't express that. We are a powerful people. We are a beautiful people, intelligent, spiritual. And I'm so proud to be a LumbeeTribe-NC every day of my life. But I'll tell you, this is going to take time. It's going to take effort. It's going to be a bit of a hike up this hill we're going to go up, where the great things are waiting for us, that God has waiting for us. But I tell you what, I don't know how many of you will stick with me or how many of you will join me. But I'm going to go up this hill. If I have to go up it on my hands and knees, I'm going up. And I want you all to join me because every one of you in here represents, there's some people in here that have 5,000 friends on Facebook. You know a lot of people. And that Facebook is a positive thing, like I just said, but it's a negative thing. And it's time, I'll keep saying it, for us to stop mutilating, hurting each other, destroying people's reputations, their jobs, their families with Facebook. We got to keep working on that. But like I said, I'm proud to be a Lumbeean, and I know you are. I'm proud every day, when I get down, someone calls me, someone sees me, and they uplift us every day. God sends people to uplift you and me every day. But I'm going to keep on going. Let's keep going together. And the last thing I'm going to say to you, God bless you, and I still believe.
Hello, 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 hello. First thing I want to do right quick is I want to apologize for my age to my elders out here. I'm a young man. I'm going to sing an honor song today for everybody. And the name of this song is Heartbeat. And the story is, among our people, as long as the beat of this drum goes, our people will never die. So one of the things that Mr. Harvey said, and it's so true, is that our culture is important, and so many of our people are returning to their culture, and this cultural rejuvenation that's happening among our people here is a beautiful, beautiful thing. So many people now are getting involved, the youth's getting involved, the elders are getting back involved with the youth, and so we're going to move our people forward. We're all going to move our people forward. So. With that being said, I hope you enjoy this song.
Ah,
Yahweh, thank you.
As you can see, I'm not Brother Tim. Let us pray. Fathers, we come before you today. We just want to say thank you. We thank you, God, because you awakened us this morning to see another day. And Father, that you watched over us through the night as we were in deep sleep, not realizing we were still in the world. But God, we were able to walk outside and feel the sun and feel the breeze as it come by our way, knowing that it was only and through by you. God, we thank you for this day that you have set aside. God, I thank you for our chairman. I thank you, Father, for the vision that he has for us as Lumbee people. God, I thank you for the words that he has spoken so powerful today. God, I'm asking now that you'd continue to bless him, continue to smile upon him. Help him, dear God, to not lean upon his own understanding, but God, in all his ways, he would acknowledge you. God, that you would lead, guide, and direct him, Lord. And Father, most of all, that we as the Lumbee people, Father, will take and follow our leader. For God, I know that he's following you. Bless our people, Lord. Touch our elders. Touch our young people. God, help us as he spoke earlier about unity. Help us, dear God, to be united together. Father, and knowing one thing, Father, in the past, there might have been some weeping through the night, but God, I thank you that joy has come to the Lumbee people. Thank you, God, for your many blessings. Thank you, God, for coming to see about us. Thanking you, God, that you never walked away, but help us, Father, to ever hold to your unchanging hand. Help us, dear God, to always be those that would be pleasing in thy sight. Strengthen now, Lord. Visit our hospitals. Touch the sick and afflicted. Help us, dear God, to always stand together. And God, as we stand, it will lift you up to a lost and dying world. Father, we thank you again for your love and your mercy. Go with us now as we go our separate ways. Bless this food now. Let it be a nourishment to the bodies. Lord God, let it give us the strength that we need. Bless the hands that have taken time to prepare it. And Father, I'll ever give you the praise, give you the glory and the honor. For it's in Jesus' holy name I do pray. And the church said, amen. Amen. I know somebody said he's getting ready to preach. No, I'm not. Amen. But we would ask you to do this if you would allow our chairman and his family to go first, and then all our elected officials if they would follow, and then allow our elders as they go in the line also. God bless you. God keep you. Let's stay together.